So.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to North Shore Live Cooper's Corner. Happy New Year, healthy, happy, prosperous New Year. It's a very exciting evening this evening because this is part two with Sonia Martin. And Sonia is a veteran and she is from the American Legion, military veteran, and she's from the American Legion Post 145 here in Highland Park. And we're going to be talking about veterans things, and it's winter time, and tonight's the Powerball. I hope everybody got their ticket. We could all use a couple of billion dollars for sure. So I hope everybody got that, and everybody had wonderful holidays. We ended 2015 with Sonia, and we're starting 2016 with Sonia because we want to help the veterans. We're very much involved with veterans, and we want to help them, and we want to do all we can for clothing, shelter, food, whatever we can do. And the weather is bitterly cold. Please contact your next door neighbors, or if you see them, make sure they're doing well. Please do not leave your dogs or any animals outside. Bring them in. Just use common sense. If the kids are not in school, keep them in the house. Too cold to really play outside. Cover their mouths and nose with the scarves, because the winter air is so desperately cold that it will affect their lungs. You won't even know it. They'll come up with a cough and then pneumonia, and that's really bad. It will not be a good thing. So take precautionary measures, just common sense. Keep candles away from curtains, or keep them in the middle of a table or on a stove. I know they look pretty and it smells lovely in the wintertime to have that barberry fragrance. They can't believe that Christmas is over, but I still love the smell of the candles and the wonderful fragrance of the wintertime. I don't like winter, but I do like the fragrance. And you're laughing, Sonia, so you probably know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
So without any further ado, please let me introduce to you my guest for the first program of our new year, 2016, Sonia Martin. Welcome.
Thank you.
And thank you for coming.
I'm so happy to be back.
Your hands, how nice. And it's so cold outside.
It is.
I know, and you've got young kids too.
I do.
And so, do you tell them to?
I tell them to bundle up.
Yes.
I tell them to put the hats on, put the gloves on, and they don't.
Oh, see? Okay.
You know, I tell them they're going to live and learn. You know,
that's terrible.
You know?
I have my grandchildren over, and they're just little kids, 4-year-old and 11-year-old, and I do have a 14-year-old. And I have to bundle them up, and they just say, I can't breathe, I can't. I said, well, you're outside, it's bitter cold.
It's for their own good.
You can't play.
No.
Well, the sleds are outside. I said, well, stay in right now.
So exactly.
We'll wait till it gets to be 72 degrees. Now, a gentleman I saw in the store today said, well, it's a wonderful spring weather we're having. I said, yes, someone should tell God it's January.
It's got us confused.
Yeah, we just have to make the best of it.
We do.
I hope this is the end and nothing is elongated.
I hope so too. You know, it's the Midwest. You know,
it feels like Antarctica. What are you telling me? Yeah, you know, Sonia, you're here because you know what's going on.
I do.
And you went to. to all those places that are so hot.
I did.
And what was the median temperature there?
In Iraq, the median temperature was probably about 120. That was a little warm. But
we could certainly melt all the snow.
Yeah, we never saw any snow, that's for sure.
Oh, and ice?
Ice.
No snow and no ice.
No, no snow and ice.
This evening's program, as I mentioned to you before, we want to talk about helping, saving, protecting the veterans, military veterans. I have to yes, preface that by saying military veterans, because there's a lot of veterans with a lot of other things, you know.
Right.
People don't know if you're, you know, a medical veteran or, you know,
Firemen.
Yeah, firemen, police officer, they yes. don't know. So those are the guys in blue, and you guys are military, so that's... So what can we do, what can our public do out there to help protect and, you know, we have to help you guys that have come back and with shelter and clothing, heavy clothing is good, wool, anything, because you have to put it on, in layers. So, for food... I know the Salvation Army has the soup kitchens that are open to feed everybody, I know some of the churches but what else can we, the people here, what can we do to help the military veterans get back on their feet, or someone knows someone,
Okay, that's a great question. Some of the things that just ordinary, regular people or anyone can do to help the veterans. One, I'll say, we'll start with jobs.
With jobs.
You know, we have a lot of veterans who are getting out of the military for whatever reason, retirement, or they just don't want to do that anymore, or whatever reason.
Their contract is up.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, they're it's time to go. And so a lot of them, when they come out, they're looking for jobs. And a lot of times, a lot of jobs, they're looking for, of course, most jobs are looking for things specific, but there may be some things that a military person hasn't done per se, that doesn't reflect on their resume or a title of what they've done, but it's something that they can do. And if they're just given the opportunity, to do the job, you know, people will see that, these individuals have talents that we didn't even know existed. Yeah. They brought something to our table that we didn't know we needed. And that's a very important thing. Is one important thing is jobs, hiring a vet. Hiring a veteran.
Now, some of the stores, they might need stock room help.
Yes.
For stock room or stock the shelves in the store.
Exactly.
Or cashiers.
Exactly.
Maintenance of some sort.
Yeah. More than capable to do that.
Light bulbs or just making sure that the front door is clear, that people can come in and go out.
Yes.
That there's no ice or snow. Do the salt or whatever.
Exactly.
So any job.
Right. Any job they're given the opportunity, to do.
And they can work from there. Work themselves up.
And work themselves up.
Some of the restaurants,
Local
restaurants, need servers, wait staff, kitchen.
Kitchen
help.
Yeah. Administrative work. You know, we have a vast array of talents that we're taught in the Army. We're not just taught our specific MOS, There are things that we have to learn. We have to learn how to do maintenance on a vehicle, even if that's not what our MOS, our job is. We have to learn how to do that,
I can put gas in a car.
Yeah.
But don't ask me about it. I can put the gas in the car. I really can't. I can put gas in.
But you have, you know, you have some soldiers that, you know, even though that's not their MOS, when they're given the task that, you know, because usually every Monday you have to go to the motor pool and do PMCS on your assigned vehicle.
Oh,
and
Sergeant Bilko.
Yeah, it's Sergeant Bilko. Okay. And a lot of them, they take that to heart, so they want to learn more. So they get with the motor sergeant. So can you show me this? Can you show me that? And so they pick up that talent. Okay. You know, and you know, that's not what they're in the Army for. That's not the job that they're there. But because we're there and it's a part of what we actually do, you know, it's something that, you know, you can learn from. You glean that information from it, and then, hey, I can put this on my resume and say, okay, yes, I can do that. So when you get out, then, you know, there's other fields that are opened up. You know, person that works in finance, you know, and they come out, they can work in a bank.
Oh, true. Bank, finance, that's right.
Exactly.
That's right.
Teachers, we have, the military has a great program, Troops to Teachers. So once you get out, you can go into the Troops to Teachers program if you want to go into the classroom.
Wow.
You know? So, you know, there are a lot of different talents that military personnel have to offer. And the only thing that gets in the way is the opportunity. You know, sometimes companies may not want to take a chance, you know, on a veteran because they've heard so much about
We have a sticker that was in our window. It's a mm-hmm. We Hire Vets.
Which is great.
We Hire Vets. Yeah,
and a lot more businesses are doing it.
And they're
every
talented.
Day. Yes.
Those that are looking yes. for job situations are very talented.
Yes, they are.
And you know, talented why not take a chance? They're Americans. Come on, you know.
Exactly. You need someone for the position. Here's someone that's willing and able and capable to do it.
Right.
You know, just take a chance and, you know, hire a veteran.
We should tell our viewing audience that if you have an establishment, if you are an owner of a store or a restaurant or whatever, if you would like to extend your hand in helpfulness, please, and you have jobs available, that's good. We have to have a job available.
Have to have a job available.
Okay.
Well, they can create a job.
Let's be
there
creative.
Exactly.
We can create a job. Between Sonia and I, yeah. we can help you create a job.
Absolutely.
To be able to establish someone for a work position.
Absolutely.
So please, where would they contact or what would they do? You know, put an ad in the paper or contact your local, American Legion or the veterans?
Yeah, any of the veterans groups, veterans organizations, American Legion, VFW, the Disabled American Veterans Organizations.
Yes, that's good.
Yes, you know, those are all great contacts that you know, that are could be go betweens. You know.
Yes, and they would be able to help and. Mm-hmm. We really would like to have some feedback. We'd like to congratulate whomever it would be that has a job position to hire a veteran. A restaurant, could be a 24-hour restaurant that, you know, as a shift, maybe they can't get there during the day, mm-hmm. but they'd rather work at night. Mm-hmm. So that would be okay.
Yeah. Flexibility.
Sandwich shops, anything that, you know, we people use would be helpful for veterans. And, of course, the pay, that would be useful as well. Maybe they don't have transportation, but mm-hmm. if you're willing to pay them a livable wage, they can perhaps pool in a car and get to work, get mm-hmm. to wherever you are. These mm-hmm. young men and women are eager for job position. Please help them. Please, the weather is really nasty out. We don't want them under a bridge. We don't want them in a paper box. We don't want them to be in a situation that they've sacrificed their very being overseas to protect everyone, mm-hmm. and yet coming home, no one is there to care about them. We don't want that. We want you to be responsible people, caring Americans, and extend your hand in helpfulness and a hand up, not just a hand out. Yes. It's pitiful to see this on the street. And if you have food and you see someone, you can even go to your local township offices and ask, mm-hmm. where is it that you can help military veterans? You want to help military veterans. They will give you names, they will give you numbers, they will give you contacts of where you can help. And they need clothing, winter clothing, boots, scarves, mittens, hats, gloves, sweaters, pants, underwear,
boots.
Yes, boots. Definitely. And now I hope that the weatherman is not correct with his below zero forecast or more snow, but you know, it's really pitiful to see that that military veteran out there in the cold without the proper attire. That's really heartbreaking. So, and we just had a friend of ours call from overseas, and the weather is just as you mentioned, 125 in the shade. And I said, you know, we can't wait for you to come home.
Oh, I bet.
And bring some heat with you. Yeah. You know, he's still over there. Mm-hmm. He's in Africa, and it's hot.
It's hot, yes.
It's hot.
It's hot.
And
it's hot.
So we're so proud of all of our military veterans that that give their all. But we want to help. And if you know of someone and you can't get them some assistance, contact me. Where's my thing? It should be... there it is. I'm pointing. There it is. Oh, there. Contact me. There. That's better. Contact me, and you'll be... I'll contact whoever it is that you need to contact. If you know of a military veteran, just contact me. Say, hey, Bev, saw your program. An over military veteran that needs some assistance. I will... Sonia and I will do it.
Absolutely.
I'm pulling her into this.
Absolutely.
She's no free ride, Sonia.
None.
So,
I got
and you've got
I'm
the
here.
Experience, so I'm going to really weigh heavy on you to be able to help
Absolutely.
Out. We need your assistance. We've got the wherewithal to do this, but we need you to tell us of the veterans, that military veterans that you might be seeing that need all of the above. Maybe even a place to live, a shelter, clothing, food, boots, everything. Maybe they left their family because they couldn't support them. And they're out in the blizzard alone. And their family doesn't know where they are. We are willing to help. Maybe they have sustained some type of traumatic brain injury and they're very... hurtful and don't know which way to turn, figure being alone is best, which is not.
It's not best.
That's not good
at
all.
That's the worst thing.
Terrible.
It is, because they need someone. They need someone that's there. They need to know that someone cares.
Cares. Absolutely. You know? Yeah. Absolutely. And we do care, and we want you to care. And this is a new year, so it would be a great... honor and a great mercy for you to be able to help the military veterans, whatever, you know, whatever their branch of service. And I'm sure that we might be talking to someone who has someone in their family who is in the military.
Yes.
So if you want to take that on, if you're Army, Navy, Marine, Air Force,
Coast Guard.
Coast Guard, yeah, we forget the Coast Guard.
The Coast Guard,
and National Guard too.
Yes.
You know, they're there too.
They are.
They are. They've been tapped on the shoulder, and they are there.
They are.
So please do help. And this, gotta get that straight here. Anyway, anything else you'd like to add to this? You came with questions or answers? We got plenty of questions. We need answers, Sonia.
Plenty of answers. Well, you know, we have so many veterans out here, and a lot of them have a lot of issues. You stated earlier about TBI.
Yeah.
We have veterans with PTSD. Of course, homelessness. We have soldiers that are contemplating suicide.
Yeah.
Soldiers, service members. You name it. So all of those disabilities. Each one of those for each individual, they all need someone to care, someone to be there with them to say, hey, you're not going through this alone.
Yeah.
And the VA has programs that are there in place that are there to help. And they do great things. They have, they offer them whatever their need is. They offer them that help and that assistance. We just have to be mindful, that service members that are going through PTSD,
With a disability,
whatever it is, a lot of times, they may act out, but it's not, it's not the person that's doing the act out, it's the circumstances that they were caught up in that keeps coming back to their minds over and over.
Yeah.
It's like a loop that just keeps going through their heads and there are triggers a lot of times that set those things off. And sometimes it happens. You may be in a restaurant and, there may be something, a loud boom outside and you may see someone, hit the floor or something, and that's a soldier that's going through some things because of some things that he's already been through. And we just have to be, just be mindful, think, okay, well, that's a service member. He's gone through some things. It's okay, tell them, we're here for you. Thank you for your service. Even if you're just in passing, it's a great thing to offer our service members encouragement, no matter what they're going through. Even if you're at a happy point, even if you're at a celebration, just because we don't know what that individual is really going through on the inside. We don't know what's going to happen once he leaves there and goes home and, he's in a quiet place, he or she. In a quiet place. We don't know what those demons are going to come back out. So if we, offer that support, that kindness, that care, that love, each and every time that we're in contact with our veterans, it goes a long way.
Very well said, and I hope that our viewers are understanding that, because someone has a traumatic brain injury, I mean, they have to come back literally, and walk their way back to how they were.
Yes,
it is a long and tedious trip.
It is. It's a very long process. It's like teaching a baby all over again.
They're afraid of loud sounds. They're afraid of quick movement. They're afraid of making statement and take it the wrong way.
Right.
They're not sure of what they're doing.
Exactly. They're guarded.
Very guarded in things that they're safe.
And we just have to be mindful that, it's not personal. It's not something that they're meaning towards you, but it's just, it's just internally what's going on with them.
And we should say that, let the public know that there are many divorces that transpire from this. Because when he or she, the military veteran, come home, they cannot be absorbed in the life that they've had before.
Exactly.
And so, the wife or the husband might be, the spouse might be saying, well, now you're over that, now you're home, but it doesn't work like that.
It doesn't work that way. And that's
how were you? How were you able to get back into the swing of things after being overseas?
I think that my faith in God was what helped me get through each of my deployments. I didn't ask God not to send me for deployments. I just asked him to keep me while I was there.
Yeah.
I prayed that he would continually keep me each and every day. And so I think my faith in God had a lot to do with, not allowing all of the harmful stuff, all of the
because it's overwhelming. The stuff. It's overwhelming.
Yeah, it didn't allow all of that to seep in.
Well, you know that God is there to protect you and all of those who serve and are serving and have served, because he can very well see that you've done your job for society and protected countries and other and people who don't even know you.
Exactly.
And so he will keep you true to his heart.
Exactly. And it does, being deployed and seeing all the things that we see, it affects you. You don't come back the same. You just learn how to deal and internalize all those things that you saw. You learn how to compartmentalize those things. You learn how to put, okay, this goes in this box. No, what I saw today goes in this box and it goes away. What I saw goes in this way. Okay, these are the happy things. I'm going to keep these right here. You know, so you just learn how to compartmentalize those things and not internalize everything that happens, you know, but for some people, they're unable to do that. And so those things keep coming back to them over and over. You know, they have nightmares. You know, they have all kinds of things that have become part of them, who's changed who they are. And so that's when they come back, you know, that's why the spouse will say, well, just snap out of it, you're not over there anymore. But they can't, because it's changed who they are. And so now they have to be who they are now and learn how to, I don't want to say normal, because that's not, you know.
No, that's relative. You don't know what normal is.
We don't know what normal is.
To be able to get back into society.
Exactly.
To function daily. Yeah, absolutely.
Be able to function daily. And that's a lot of the reason why divorce rates are pretty high after deployment.
Skyrocketing.
Because, you know, a lot of times the service member will push the spouse away, and at some point the spouse can't take it, and they go, you know, and because they want what they had before,
And you know, the worst of all of this is not only on the mother and the father, but if there's children, little children, they want to see their mommy or their daddy, but the mind and the stress of being overseas, of what they've seen, what they've heard, you know, you see these things on TV. It's heartbreaking, because they were there. They fought the fight. You were there. It's a good thing, you know, you married military, so both you and your husband are military. So, that it's understandable, because you can understand him. He understands you. And you raised a family. So all the kids have got, you know, together. Understanding with military, but we want to help. We want to do all that we can. I can't impress upon my viewers enough to please extend your hand and helpfulness. And even if you know, we should do is make a food drive. There's got to be a food drive somewhere. Moraine Township. Yeah, Moraine Township, do a food drive for military veterans. I mean, please contact me, or I'll contact you. I mean, don't let sit idle.
We can be proactive.
We have to. Now, when is the next meeting that you guys have for the American Legion? When is your next?
Our next luncheon will be March.
March.
Not January or February, but March.
We should have some input between now and March, so that, you know, you can get up there. And I mean, you're Sergeant at Arms, are you not?
Yes, I am.
Okay, Sergeant at Arms. You can say, we've done this, and we want everybody to know. And can veterans come? Is there free of charge to veterans, or military veterans?
Military veterans, free of charge.
Let them come. Exactly. Let them know that they're wanted.
Exactly. That they're part of the group, that we care. Absolutely.
Okay, so can I say that? Can I tell it now on the air?
You can tell it.
Yes. Or you want to tell it on the air? You tell it. Go ahead, Sonia.
All right. Any veteran that's out there that wants to come, we have our lunches of the American Legion the second Tuesday of each month at the Highland Park Recreation Center at 11:30. You're more than welcome to come, have a meal. We have a speaker. Enjoy the speaker and come and feel a part of the comradeship. You know, we love our brothers and sisters in arms, and we care that each and every one of you are out there, and we want you to be a part of our organization and what we're doing. And we just want you to know that we are there. So please come out and join us.
That would be wonderful. And you know, another thing is, maybe they can see this or they're watching this, but they don't have the viability of transportation. So if there's someone out there that needs to get to this VFW, it's American Legion. Yeah, yes. American Legion.
Give me a call.
Give Sonia a call. We will work together, and because she's my comrade in arms now.
Absolutely.
I mean, now that she's attached, that's it. She is attached.
Absolutely.
So please let us know, and we'll be able to get you a ride to go there, have lunch, a free lunch for American Legion here up in Highland Park, meet your brethren and sister, and know that we care. People out there do care. They care if you are in need, that we'll get you whatever assistance, whatever services you might need, or clothing you might need. You will not leave empty-handed. You will have many people beside you to know that you gave your service and that you care. And we care that you were there. That's the truth. We care that you were there. Is there any kind of fundraising that will be going on at any time? Do you know that if the American Legion will be having anything?
Not right now. We'll have a meeting next month, and I will bring that up because surely there's something that we can do. You know.
Bring up about canned goods and food and stuff like that. That will be good. I'll be happy to.
Absolutely.
And then we could take pictures of it and show it here on the air of what you know we accomplished, because you certainly have the experience and I've got the ability to make this airborne here.
Yes.
whatever. So we're
together.
Gonna,
we can get
we're
it
gonna
done.
Get it done. Yeah,
yes,
get it done. Anything that you need to do, and we want to thank Larry Sosarossi and Michael Zimmerman for their help, because they're the Larry's the commander.
Yes.
So
yes, he is. He's doing a great job.
Yeah, at the American Legion Post 145 in Highland Park. So that would be that's important. And you know, we got to last time when we were talking about your service overseas, but we never quite got you back home. How you got there, but where, you know, your deployment before you came home, where were you?
I was my deployment in I was in Bamberg, Germany. And I deployed to Iraq, and then I PCS'd to Fort Hood, to the 89th MP Brigade. And that's when I did two more deployments with them to Iraq.
To Iraq.
The first one was pretty, it was a deployment. You know, we had some, we had some tragedies that we...
You mentioned.
Yeah, we had some tragedies that we went through, we lost some great service members from our unit, but that's it happens,
but
every time it takes a part of your heart away each and every time that it happens.
This is so bad.
But but as a whole, we made it out. We had a great commander who took very good care of the soldiers that we had, and we made it home, and which is a good thing, And my last deployment with them, we got bombed a lot. Our buildings
bombed.
we got bombed quite a bit, but overall, we all made it home.
It's. I mean, that's incredible. I mean, we could just sit down and write a whole book on really on your deployment and whatever, and just the loss. Every mother feels that loss of their child, no matter what their age. When they come to the door with the chaplain with them, that's very hard. You don't want to see that. You don't want to know that.
No, you don't want to see it. You don't want to know it.
No.
But we did. You know, we did great. You know, we had a lot of great moments. You know, and so we had a lot of great positive things to look forward to. You know, I think I told you before. We went Christmas caroling in Iraq. Who would have thought you go Christmas caroling in the desert, you know? But
well, you got the camels there. That's good. That's a good prop. You've got the camels.
Yeah, we had the
besides
camels.
The jeeps that are there and the tanks. That's all right.
And the tanks. But yeah. So it wasn't all dark. You know, I should say. You know, we had a lot of great positive moments that we could look back on, you know. So, and of course the facilities were a lot much better than my first deployment. We had actual trailers that we could go into to take showers and actual restrooms that
worked.
That worked, yes. Flushed. Running water. Yes, we had
and
that.
Running water, wow.
Yes. We had phone service and TV, so, you know, we had some of the, you know, accoutrements of home, you know, but, you know, we were still deployed, you know, we understood our mission each and every day that we woke up.
Yeah.
And that we went to bed, we knew we were there, you know, for a purpose.
I think the public just takes military for granted, you know.
True.
Fire department, police department.
Right.
You know, they take them for granted. Do this, do that. Nobody shows or says a thank you. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your courage. Thank you for being there. Mm-hmm. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you for keeping the American flag free. And, you know, it's very important. We've got all these political people, and I'm telling you, I'm just I'm fed up to my earlobes with
aren't
it.
We all.
We have a whole year to go.
Yes.
It's just getting a little.
It's been too much too soon.
Yeah, and they've been at it for almost a year. Could you believe it? Yeah, when they started in, it was June. Will be a year that we've already been
we've
having.
Already been having.
Yeah. Yeah. Holy cow.
Yeah, it's too much.
Whomever it may be. They better know that this is America, and that we love our country.
Yes, we do.
We want to protect our country.
We do.
And we don't want anybody going anywhere that they don't have to, and to be forceful, because America doesn't take a backseat to any country.
No, we
anyone.
Don't.
We never take a backseat.
No, we don't.
And we don't intend to.
No, we don't.
So, some of those politicians that are in office, time to get out.
Yes.
Get out, because we're not going to vote you in. We've had enough of you. So promises, and we don't need that. We need to see work. We need to see the product
Complete.
Action. Exactly. Yeah, we need the action.
Action.
We need the action. Yeah, absolutely, we do. We do. So all you politicians listening, and I know that you do, you know, if you're not doing a good job, we're not keeping you in there 30 years. Forget that. You don't need that pension. We need somebody who's going to be able to do their job and stop pulling the wool over the public's eyes. You say you're going to do something, then do it. If you can't, move over. Time to, you know, relieve that chair. And I saw some politicians on the program that was on last night that I recognized from up here, and I'm not happy with that. People say, well, what do we care? And I say, well, I have a vote.
That's
might
right.
be one, but it's
That's
a
right.
vote. So
Absolutely.
Vote
Every vote counts.
Yeah, everybody has an opportunity to vote. Make it count. Put the right one in office. And if you're not happy with what you see, write somebody in. But you've got opportunity. Tired of being lied to, tired of being abused and assaulted. And, you know, if it was your son or your daughter there in Benghazi, you know, you wouldn't have wanted them to be left behind, especially knowing the truth. And I'm anxious to see the picture 13, which comes out Friday, about Benghazi. And we'll have more to talk about. And Sonia will certainly be back on the program again. We're going to be talking more about that. So, yes, when you have come from a military family and have those that serve in the military, you want them to be protected. You don't want a politician just signing their name and making promises that they cannot keep our people safe. If you have any comment, hey, there's my email, and contact me and let me know what you think. And if you want to come on the air, I'd be happy to have a discussion with anyone. Come on the air. I don't care if you're political. I'll have a discussion with you. And you better know that everybody's going to want to have a discussion with you. Right, wrong, whatever it is, we'd like to let you know the truth. This program is, we're on the air, I'm going to say, more than 30-some years. Yeah.
Wow.
Although everybody, I'm not that. I'm not going to claim that age grouping.
That's
but,
all right.
Yeah. Since Highland Park first connected with cable, and that's how long I've been on the air, a long time. And I'm the only one still standing doing a live program. I've been grandfathered in because everybody else kind of, petered away, and we're not doing that. We have things to say that affect the community,
absolutely,
that affect politicians, that affect life, real life. And we want the public to know. We've always told the truth, and every time we're on the air. And we want you to know that if you have something to say and no one has heard it, we gladly give you a platform to speak about it. And you come down to the studio and you talk about what the situation is, and we're happy to discuss it. Could be anything, dealing with the court system, dealing with not being, your sidewalks not being plowed, or whatever, and whatever community you're in, we're happy to have you. We are happy to have anyone viewing this program on the program if you want to say something or tell the public something. As long as you're in the ruling of the FCC and you don't get carried out of hand. But one thing we do request is that if you are making a statement, if you have paperwork to back up the statement, a black and white on paper, so you can't just come down and make statements or condemn someone without having very viable information. We would respectfully request that. So, and we're still waiting for our mayor here, Nancy Rotering, to come on the program. She's been invited 4 times. I mean, she was invited, but unfortunately, her timeline, 4 different times, we made allowances because she had speeches to give or whatever. But we're still waiting. So, anytime that you're available, Nancy, you know that we will certainly make room for you here on the program. She is Nancy Rotering, our mayor here from Highland Park. And we want to, let the public know who she is and introduce her on our program. And we're happy that she's our mayor, and we want to acknowledge that. So we don't have much time left, so we need to get in what we need to now, and we'll pick up this when, you know, the American Legion gets back for their luncheon, and we hopefully will have some people that will come.
Oh, absolutely. Hopefully
that, that would be good. And if they can contact you, how do they contact you, Sonia? If they want to, if they're a military veteran and they want to come to that luncheon free of charge, which is for all American veterans,
yes.
How do they contact you to say, I saw you on cable, I want to come, what do I do, how do I get there, whatever. How do they do that?
Okay, I can give my phone number, and they can they can call
you.
Me. They can call me at my home phone number. It's 847-926-3419. 847-926-3419. And you can call me. You can leave a message if I don't pick up. But please contact me, and we would be more than happy to have any veteran that wants to come to come.
Good,
absolutely.
Good. I would be very excited to see, you know, isn't the Legion? Aren't you guys looking for more membership?
We're always looking for members.
Okay.
We are always looking for members. And any military veteran of any of the veterans of or any of the military services are welcome to join the American Legion. You just contact me. Contact the our American Legion. Come to a luncheon.
To a luncheon.
If you see us out in the neighborhood, you see someone with a hat or a jacket on, just come up to us and say, hey, I want to be a part of the organization, and we will give you the information, and we'll get you hooked up with us.
That'll
Absolutely.
Be great. That'll be great.
It's great.
That will be wonderful.
We're always looking for new members.
New members, okay. Yes. And people are very warm and greeting, and you can sit anywhere you want to.
Yes.
People will take you to come sit at our table.
Absolutely. And, it's a very very friendly atmosphere, very welcoming, you know, atmosphere. You know, everyone's welcome. We don't want anyone to ever feel like they're, you know, they're an outcast. They're a stranger.
No,
you know,
there's no strangers at our table.
You've donned the boots, there are no strangers.
There are no strangers at our table. They're all welcome to come, and we're very happy to have them there.
Yes.
And so I think we should just go over what we did before, because time is fleeting, and I want to make sure that our public knows what they can do for our military veterans. So help me here. Clothing or
clothing. Clothing. You've had warm clothing, coats, boots, hats, whatever it is to help them throughout this weather. You can drop those at the VA. Actually, you can drop them at the VA, or if you know someone that's in need, just give it to them.
Give it
to
them.
Just give it to them.
Okay.
For food, the VA also
they have a food pantry.
They don't have a food pantry, but I think they have like a food voucher system for certain situations that they'll help with. And if they can't, then they have places within North Chicago, Waukegan, within the North Shore where they can help them.
Okay.
Or they can send them to that will offer assistance also. What else? For our homeless vets.
Homeless.
Our homeless vets
weather.
As well. The VA has a
shelter.
Liaison.
They have a liaison.
They have a person. That can be contacted at levels, and they'll get them into contact with places that offer shelter and other things to help them to get back on their feet, you know, with different things that they may need.
Pads also, Pads of Lake County, they could help.
They can help
veterans.
Yes,
yeah.
They can help veterans.
So Pads of Lake County, there you go. Oh, thank you, Vic. Thank you. Pads of Lake County, contact them. If you know of someone who is a veteran and they don't have the availability of a laptop or any kind of mechanical. Here's the number. There's the number you could call, and tell them that you have knowledge of a veteran who needs a place to be at, to get them out of the cold and out of the viaducts and into someplace warm, and they will tell you. They will give you instructions on how to get them there or what to do. PADS is wonderful. We've had them on the program. They're a great outfit to deal with, to work with. And I'm very proud that Lake County has stepped up and stepped to the plate to be able to help everyone in need. Even mothers and children, if they're homeless, that's a great thing. So if you're a military veteran, because this program is predicated on military veterans, but we will help everyone, anyone in need, we will extend our hand to help you. So PADS is good. The VA hospital or whatever, you could call them too.
Yes.
In North Chicago, they will give you some assistance. You just tell them that you have a friend or you know of someone who is in need. How can you get them services? Yes. That's it. The idea is the services
exactly.
to do that. And if you want, we can have you on the program. If you've received any of these services and you'd like to talk about it, we'd be delighted to have you on the program. Yeah. Sonia will sit right next to me, and we're going to have her on the program. We will. I tell you, we will. We'll have
yes,
her on the program.
We will.
And what we're going to do is then they can talk shop, and we'll just talk whatever it is
Absolutely.
That we can make them comfortable because... this is very important. This is humanity, ladies and gentlemen. This is humanity. Please extend your hand. This is a wonderful, wonderful feeling that you get, and this is a new year. This is a new program and a new year. So please help us help others, and that's exactly what we're doing. I mean, we don't take any pay for this. All volunteer. Everything we do has been volunteer. The good, the bad, and the ugly, but it's volunteer. So if you have any questions about anything, you can contact me or you can contact Sonia. This will be by the grace of whatever on the internet. And there you go. Thank you, Vic. There, this guy is remarkable. Vic Walter, wonderful, wonderful human being. Outstanding.
Outstanding.
We have to have him in front of the camera.
There you go.
Because he's great. He's wonderful. And he, you know, really knows plenty. So this is going to be on YouTube. And if you want to check this out on YouTube, and you'll see beautiful Sonia sitting next to me. And all her information. This lady provided the service to our country and the experience. I can only provide you with the service to get you on the tube and that service. So anyway, we don't have much time. It's fleeting. This is
it goes
time
quickly,
I told you.
Absolutely.
Anything you can think of quickly?
The only thing I can think of is for people in the community, the Great Lakes has different things throughout the year. Go out there, enjoy, you know, see what the soldiers, see what the sailors do. You know, it's okay.
Great Lakes.
Go out there, you know, get involved. You know, it's okay. No one's going to tell you to go away because you're a civilian.
They're afraid, I think.
A lot of people are afraid.
They're afraid.
They don't
know what to do.
Exactly.
But
if they just come. That's all they have to do.
Okay.
If they just come, you know, and get involved, and that'll help people get a better understanding.
You know, maybe if someone with military can come with a civilian and show them that this is what happens on base, that would be appropriate.
Yes.
You get clearance at the gate and whatever else, but I mean, so the civilian doesn't feel, well, that's, you know, we can't go there, we don't know anything about it, we're afraid, we're...
Exactly.
Not so. I mean, Here in the police department, you know, you ask for a tour, they give you a tour. The fire department's more than welcoming anybody for a tour. They want the public to know that they provide public service. They provide the public with life-saving services in case anything happens.
It is. And the Navy Museum is right there at Great Lakes, and it's any civilian, you can, anyone can go in there at any time. It's not on the base itself. It's joined with it, but anyone, you know, anyone in the community can go to the little Naval Museum that they have there, and it's a great place to start if you just want to start getting involved.
You know,
it's a great place to start.
I think the public wants to see what our military did and does and will do and can do and our capabilities.
Yeah. The Great Lakes Naval Museum is a great
place
to start.
That's a terrific place to start.
Great place to start.
Great place to start.
It's free. You just go in and look and get your little earphones and...
And you get the story.
You get the story.
That's right.
It's a great place to start.
That's right. So anyway, I'm... so happy you made it down here in this below zero weather. And please, again, we need to tell everybody, do not send the kids out to play. It is way too cold. And don't keep your animals outside. Bring them in. Put little sweaters on them or booties or whatever. What all else we have to... and, you know, if you want to contact the Salvation Army, you can do that and bring clothes to them as well.
Yes.
We'll connect with Salvation Army and have them on the program if you so desire.
Absolutely.
We could do that.
Sonia. Yes, they do a great job.
I can talk from experience. I've used the services of the Salvation Army. So I know
That's
what
wonderful.
That means. I've lived through that. I've been through it.
They're
and
there.
They were wonderful.
Awesome. And they're
still
They were
lifesavers.
Yeah.
And I was a child, and it was really horrific. But we want to thank you all for allowing us in your home or your place of business. And a happy new year, a healthy, happy new year. And congratulations to whoever wins that billion whatever Powerball. I'm going to be so excited. I can't wait for next week to come already. And we'll win it. So thank you all for watching, and see you next week on North Shore Live Cooper's Corner. Have a safe evening, a pleasant week, and stay warm. Stay warm. God bless you all. Happy New Year 2016. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you.